My check, 1, 2. 1, 2. 1, 2. My check, 1, 2. My check, 1, 2. One, two, checking.
We're just bringing everyone in. The choirs are all coming to get into their spots. Those of you that are coming up to are coming to hear, I see they're already in the right spots. I know that there's a program. I don't know if all of you got a chance to get a copy. You got it. Good. I like that. Good. Mike, wherever you are, you can get that first. Okay, so it's 2 minutes after seven. I'm feeling already that I haven't started on time. So I'm going to get started. My name is Peter Luongo. I am a longtime member of St. Matthew's community. In fact, usually see me at 10:30 at the 10:30 Mass. I'm the very calm director. Seldom very calm. Tonight is a very special. We had this little thing called COVID that happened. Remember that? And during that, we stopped a process of having choirs from St. Matthew get up and share at Christmas time their music. So we had 3 years where, quite frankly, didn't have anybody in the church, and we continued to put on an event. And then we returned for a couple of years with a group that was made up of all the choirs of different masses and community members, and we put together a chorus, sang carols, and we had that presentation. And this year, we'd like to restart that tradition of having event where our church's choirs, our St. Matthew's parish community choirs, have a chance to share and come together with you. This is truly intended to be an Advent event as we prepare for that very special moment, the Christmas celebration, Christ's birth that we celebrate. So, I'm going to sing like this, because I don't like it when the thing does that. So, I'm going to risk my voice. Can you all hear me? Yeah. All right, Chow, you're going to get it right, right? Okay, thanks, Chow. So, I'm going to start by inviting Father to come up and lead us in prayer, so that we can begin incorrectly, and then we'll introduce our first group. Father.
Well, thank you, Peter. I think it's too loud, that's why. It's too loud. See? Echoing. So turn it down a wee bit, Cal. Well, thank you for being here. So wonderful for us to be together once again in this joyous season, the season of waiting, of preparing for the birthday of our Savior once again. So this season, and of course, this into the season of Christmas, is filled with music, songs, singing, and bring the love and the warmth of Christ, love, grace to our own heart. So our parish has had this tradition of having the Christmas concert for many years now. So now we gather together with many choirs, different groups of our parish community, so to sing and to praise God and to give glory to Him, and also to bring joy to each and every one of us. Let us give thanks to God for this chance, for this time, and let us pray that He will bless us with the enjoyment of the performance of all the choirs in our parish community. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, Amen. Loving God, we give you thanks for the gift of life, for the gift of faith and salvation to our Lord Jesus Christ as we prepare ourselves once again to celebrate the birth of our Savior. We ask you to bless our joy, our friendship that we're sharing with one another as a parish community of St. Matthew's. We ask you to bless all the choirs, all the performances tonight who are using their talent and love to give you praise, glory, and bring joy to our own heart. We ask you to bless the Paris Christmas concert tonight. We ask this to Christ our Lord. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Well, enjoy.
Thanks, Father. You had the power to get the mic turned down. I like that. All right. So if we can get that first group up, please. They're coming. Here they come. Hey, how are you doing? So we are truly blessed in this parish. We have, I think, seven different masses, and every mass has its own choir. And every choir is unique in what it does and how it does it and its makeup. And so it really is a chance to celebrate that diversity of choirs that we have. Of course, two of our choirs that are going to be presenting here tonight, actually maybe two, because we have both the middle-aged, that would be all the women, the older folks, that would be the men, and then we have the children. So we have a Vietnamese community that we can really celebrate and who brings their own style of music to the presentation. So the very first presentation we have tonight is Our Lady of Lavang Choir under the direction of Vincent Nguyen. They have 28 members. Tonight they're performing Peaceful Night. Please welcome them.
Thank you.
Our Lady of Louvain Choir. Thank you, Vincent. That was great. Vincent, as the choir leaves, just stay with me for a minute. Turn around, face the audience. This is the director, Vincent. Could you give Vincent another hand for the great work he's doing with this group? So, can you just translate a little bit of the message of what was just sung about?
Yes, dear the audience, the song was about Christmas night. Very peaceful. The entire world is welcoming the Savior. So this is one of the traditional songs in Vietnam. And a lot of people in Vietnam are very proud of this song. A lot of people know this song, they can sing by heart. So we like to bring this song here to share what you are on this Christmas season. Thank you.
Nice job. Way to go, Vincent. Way to go. Merry Christmas. Okay, so many of the choirs gathered tonight and warmed up. They took a room somewhere in the church and they got a quiet space and they practiced. This next choir just showed up for 5:30 Mass, which they do every 5:30 Mass on Saturday nights. So they're ready. They're ready to rock and roll here, or to sing Christmas. So you got it. Thank you. I saw that. Now, this is the 5:30 choir. They are formally known as Chorus Angelorum, and they are led by Danny Barnabes. Danny, he's coming. There he is, right where we left him. It's Danny, it's great to see you. I'm telling you, it is great to see you. Lovely. They're going to do two numbers for us, Christmas Grace and Christmas in Our Hearts. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Chorus Angelorum. chorus, Angelorum Choir. Well done, you guys. Nice work. Nice work, Danny. Way to go. You know, I mentioned to you, we're so blessed. I mean, you saw that the Vietnamese community is well represented. The Filipino community is also extremely well represented in our choirs, and none more so or no less so than in that choir that just performed for you in Chorus Angelorum. The next group that we're going to have up is going to be our young people. And it is so vital for us as a church community that we have our young people involved in events like this. The future singers, the people that will sing at Mass in the future, are the people that are coming up behind me now. They're the people that will be continuing to be part of our community, to grow our community, and to continue our faith in this church community. So I am just absolutely delighted that these young people have come. These are Our Lady of Lavang Vietnamese Children's Choir, 35 to 40 members, and they're not the only children's group that's going to perform tonight, which is also exciting for me. They are under the direction of Tot and Mylin Phan, and they are going to do one of my very favorite pieces. They are going to sing, remember, this is the Vietnamese choir, right? They're going to sing Feliz Navidad. I love it. Good stuff. Way to go, man. Welcome. Give them a big hand. Thank you. Vietnamese children's choir. Oh yeah. Yeah. Nice job. Now, tell me, tell everybody here, how old is the youngest child that's there?
The youngest, he start from 7 years old to 14 years old. We are the teacher the our language every Sunday from 12:30 within the 2:30 p.m. We want to keep the tradition of the Vietnamese language. I think it's not easy for the kids, but we try, do the best. Hey, I have to say thank you for everyone here. Thank you for Luang Go. That one is the good metro in the world.
Stop it. Hey, thank you, man. So again, it's really great. And of course, they come up, they're Vietnamese choir and they're singing Spanish. I love it. It's perfect. Okay, so we were blessed. How many remember when Father Obiwama was here? Remember, we were really blessed at that time that a number of folks from the African community came into our area of St. Matthews. You've seen already Filipino community, Vietnamese community. I know there's an Italian community. But this is really neat because this was a group of folks who came and have stayed in this community. And I just think it's absolutely great. They do one of our masses at 10:30, one of the masses at 10:30 a month. Sorry, change that, 12:30, one a month. And they actually continue their traditions in the African community. And so I'm so delighted that we have kept this group of people. I'm delighted that they have a music presentation for us. They're under the direction of Tina Obiwama. There are 15 members. They're singing Love is My Christmas Gift and another piece that's in African that I'm not even going to try. Do you want to say it?
Which one?
This one.
Ekeresimese lutego.
Easy for you to say. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the African Community Choir.
Dum 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 d
under the direction of Tina Omiwama. Well done, you guys. Nice. I think it's so good that they got their teenage members in the front row. All the teenagers they got from the African community. It's so good. Tina, that was really good. Can I ask you to explain that the second piece, what the lyrics were about? Because I didn't understand.
It explains the process that Mary and Joseph went through and how baby Jesus was born, how the angels came and visited. And it's also to announce the whole world that the Savior is born.
Oh, what a great message. Thank you, Tina. Great work. You can leave that there. Thank you, dear. Yeah, how could you not move? Like, I was sitting over there doing that, and I'm usually very calm. Oh, so it's going to be like that. Okay, I see. So, I don't know. Again, you know, I remember moving into the Fleetwood community. Oh my goodness, it must have been 30 years ago. 30, 35 years ago. And they didn't have a church. Like St. Matthew's wasn't built. They had a high school gym. And so my family and I would go to Mass. And we loved going on Sunday night. Because, first of all, we could get in. Secondly, the music was awesome. And, you know, Nanette was providing the music at that time. Like, she's been here, like, forever. And the thing is, she's found, obviously, the fountain of youth, because, like, she doesn't look any different today than she did back then. So, yeah, right? So we truly are blessed. We have a gift in the fact that we have a person that has been involved in the music ministry here at St. Matthew's for as long as there has been a church. And Nanette continues to make it a special experience for all of those who go to Mass on Sunday nights. Please, ladies and gentlemen, welcome.
To make a little noise with the mics since we don't have that many bodies with us here, but you know, lots of things have evolved over these many, many years since 1986 in the gym. Yes, I'm the resident fossil. I even call myself that, so it's okay. But tonight's kind of special because Flavio joined me going on 2 years ago now, which has been awesome. Everybody at 7:30 Mass really enjoys the rhythm, which is great. And special tonight, I have my granddaughter Marissa, who's 5, and she's going to sing with her Nana tonight for all of you. So I'm very happy to have her. Yes. And you can see that she doesn't look like her Nana, she looks like her mommy. And her mommy actually did sing with me for 14 years, so here at St. Matthew's. So I'm happy that she could come and sit here with her daughter. So here we go. So you probably all know that our choir at 7:30 Mass is actually where you are right now in the pews. So I'm expecting all of you to sing along with us, okay? Hello. Yeah, good. All right. Jesus. But not very much, and we're in Advent and it's Christmas, so we're going to sing Happy Birthday Jesus, not the traditional one, but we'd like you to sing along with us too if you like. Here we go. Happy birthday Jesus, I'm so glad it's Christmas, all the tinsel and lights and everything's bright. Happy birthday, Jesus. I'm so glad it's Christmas. All the carols and bells. Second time be better. Happy birthday, Jesus. I'm so glad it's Christmas. All the tinsel and lights. Thank you. Thank you. Merry Christmas, everyone.
Give me one of those. You know how to do that? I like it. There you go, Mom.
Thank you.
Good. Ladies and gentlemen, let's give another hand to Nanette and the Glory Guitar Ministry. The whole. Chow, just so you know, I've changed mics. I've got the other one now. This one's better. It doesn't feed back. So as the next group comes up, I just want to make a couple of announcements. You'll notice in the program that it's got a QR code. This event has traditionally been the event where we generate some funds for the St. Vincent de Paul. Now, I better make sure I say this correctly. Donations to St. Vincent de Paul Society. So this is not money that comes back to us. It doesn't go to the choirs. It doesn't go to the church. It goes to the St. Vincent de Paul Society. So if you're so inclined, it would be absolutely wonderful if at some point tonight, later, tomorrow, whenever it moves you, if you could donate something to that society that does such great work for the Catholic community, actually for the whole community, but one of our Catholic charities. The other thing that I want to mention is that we have a number of people that have helped put this together. Chow is on the sound, he's worked this all out, but I have two people in particular. Tim McKinnon had a real influence in making sure this went right through all of our time through COVID and restarting, and so it would be appropriate. I don't even know where he is, but he's in the room. Could you please give a big hand to Tim McKinnon? Thank you. Great. And I've noticed that Bill and his team have been excellent at getting groups up, so it's moving the evening along. So again, to Bill Bauman and his crew, let's give them a hand too. Nicely done. That's up. Good. Ladies and gentlemen, the next group you will recognize from our 8:30 Mass on Sunday mornings. This is the Novalis Choir. They are under the direction of Jermaine Joaquin, who is just over behind the piano. And in fact, there are 22 members and they look amazing. And again, there's a young member and then a bunch of middle-aged members and then the old folks are in the back. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the Novalis Choir. Thank you. The Novalis Choir. Nicely done. Sweetheart, can you come here? Come, come. We're about the same size, so it's good. Let's come right over here. Come here. Can you tell everybody what your name is?
Juliana.
Juliana, can you tell everybody how old you are?
7.
Juliana, do you love to sing?
Yeah.
Do you know what? We all loved listening to you. I just want you to know that. Could you have another hand for Juliana, please? Well done, sweetheart. God bless you. Great. See, the future. I love it. I love it. Now, speaking of the future, I had a chance to, Sandy and I had, my wife and I had a chance to go and see the Christmas play that St. Matthew's put on earlier this week. How many of you had a chance to go do that? Well, if you got a chance to do it, you got a great show and a great message. Young lady wasn't quite sure about this whole Jesus thing, being born in a stable and being the savior, but she figured it out by the end. It was really good. Great story. No commercials. I liked it. And so from the school, that we have the choir that's here, and they're under the direction of Janine Marr. Ms. Marr has come back. She said she retired, but I told her she was way too young. Not allowed. So she's come back to work with the children, and she's working with the children at St. Matthew's, and I think they're really blessed to have her as a part of their school teaching team. The children are blessed to have her as a teacher, and today she's brought the choir. Thank you, Ms. Marr. And they're going to sing two songs for us, Emmanuel and Born This Day. And it looks to me like we have a representation of the choir. Am I right about that? Okay, not the full thing. Okay, but that's good. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome our St. Matthew's Choir.
Thank you.
the direction of Ms. Marr. Well done, guys. That's terrific. Terrific. Thank you. Great job. Thank you, boys and girls. You're going to go that way? You know, it's interesting. Again, a great cross-section of our community represented in the children that are in that choir. Just such a great job. Could you give them another hand? That was terrific. Way to go, you guys. Good job. So as the next group comes up, we actually have three acts left. We have this choir, and then we have a very special guest that's going to sing for you. Ooh, who could it be? Well, you'll find out. No, it's not Father Tran. No, it's okay. Maybe Father Mark? No, it's not. I wouldn't do that to you. Father Mark, I wouldn't do that. You're new. Usually we get the new priest to sing a solo. Yeah, I'm in trouble tomorrow. Confessional, I'm dead. Done. Okay. So our next choir is again from our Vietnamese community, Triumph of the Cross Choir, under the direction of Hoang Nguyen. There are 14 members, and they're going to sing A Manger in the Winter's Night and Born of Mary. Please welcome Triumph of the Cross Choir.
Thank you.
Triumph of the Cross Choir, under the direction of Hoang Nguyen. Okay, they go, you stay here. I remember when you were shorter than me. Oh, yeah. Like, Hoang, you've been in this community for an awful long time, since you were a little girl, right?
Yeah.
And I'm so, you know what, I could not be happier to see you leading the choir. Congrats. Could you give this lady another hand, please? So just while the next choir is coming up, can you tell everybody a little bit about the first song and what the words were about?
Yeah, so the first song is A Manger in a Winter's Night. So it's about how Jesus came down in a cold winter's night to save humanity, bring peace to the world. So that was the gist of the first song.
It's a traditional Vietnamese piece?
Yeah, it's a common piece. It's more modern. So many people, especially the Vietnamese, would know about the song.
Excellent. Thank you again. Well done. Congratulations. Good. Okay, so I said you had a special guest coming, right? Now, you know him. It's not Father Tran, it's not Father Mark, but it is Father Patrick Lay. Yes, Father, come. So Father, because he didn't want to leave things to the last minute, he notified me yesterday.
And we practiced today.
And we practiced today for a brief moment. And by the way, he said, could the choir back me up? I said, really? Like today? He said, yeah. So Father's going to sing a lament. And I'm going to have you just speak briefly about what the lament's about. Not a homily, okay? All right.
Yes. So it's quite interesting to think of singing a lament during Advent, but that it really encapsulates the season and the feeling of Advent, because Advent is a beautiful juxtaposition of two feelings. It's first of all the deep recognition of our fallen state, and it's second of all the great joy that we have a Redeemer coming. And these two things, in Jewish lament, it always ends on a joyful note. And so it's a lament, but it's a hopeful lament. It's a joyful lament. And just a quick thing on what it's saying. This is coming from the first reading of the first week of Advent that we just heard. Ye heavens, open from above, the clouds may rain the just one. Do not be angry, Lord our God. No longer be mindful that we have sinned before you. And it goes through all the ways that we have sinned, but it also has this beautiful refrain, asking for heaven to open from above. One more thing is it encapsulates the longing of the Old Testament, the longing of Holy Mother Church for the coming Messiah. Mm.
Yagien Rorate Celide Super Anubis Pluant Justu. Be angry, Lord our God. No longer be mindful that we have sinned before thee. See how Zion, thy city, now is left abandoned. Zion is left unguarded now. Jerusalem now is desolate. House of thy sanctification and of thy glory, where our fathers sang thy praises. With some loathsome thing and have fallen down, just like leaves in the blast of winter. And the sins we have committed, just like winds have blown us all about. Thou hast taken from us thy brightness and comfort, and thou hast broken us by laying the debt of our sins upon us. Turn to us and see thy chosen people's affliction, and send down him who is to come, the one promised Lamb, and yet Lord of all lands, from Petra in the desert to the mountain of Zion, thy daughter, that he may bring pardon, freeing us captives of our burden. Ye heavens, open from comforted, be thou comforted, hear me, my people. Soon shall come to thee Christ thy Savior. Why dost thou give way to sorrowing? Hath this grieving ended thy sadness? Thy Savior cometh, do not be fearful, for it is I, thy God and thy mighty ruler. Zion's Holy One and thy Redeemer. Ye heavens, open from above, the clouds may rain the just Ye heavens, open from above, the clouds may rain the just
Don't talk. So this is the 10:30 choir. They sing each Sunday morning at 10:30, unless they're not there. And the first piece is, obviously, some of you remember a group called Boney M. That's sort of their rendition, so you're nodding like this. That's good. And this next piece is really special. It's a piece that was done a long time ago, and the king of the day so enjoyed it that he stood up in the middle of the piece. And because the king stood up, everybody else stood up. So there's this tradition that I don't expect you to follow because we don't have any kings in the room. When the Handel's Messiah is sung, the audience stands. You don't need to do that, okay? If you're so moved to do it, just be aware of the people behind you. Ladies and gentlemen, the 10:30 choir would like to present now Handel's Messiah, the Hallelujah Chorus.
Hallelujah. Thank you. Thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen, take a bow. Thank you. Okay, this is the hope that will inspire you to give to the offering. So in fact, the baskets are coming, right? Basket, see, they got them. And what we're gonna do at this time is we're gonna have the other choirs come up because we're gonna get you to sing with us two final pieces. But if the offering could happen now, and the other choirs could start making their way up, please. And just gather all around. Go for it. Please, don't be shy. Come. Now, the hymnals have the song Joy to the World and Silent Night. Those two songs I know are in the hymnal. I know because I found them. If you'd like to open the hymnal and join us in singing, you are absolutely welcome to do so. Please, come. Gather. Yes. You bet. Right up front, guys. Come on, kids. Right up front. You bet. We had this adage at school, short kids in the front. Good, yeah, good. Well, you're kind of a tall kid. You're really, this is not fair. No, you, sir, trade spots with this guy. You're the right size for the front row, right here. You're supposed to be there. Yeah, there should be a rule against that height. What grade are you in? Grade six, jeez. Yeah. I love it. You know, as they're coming up, folks, would you not agree that St. Matthew's is a blessed place to have so many great music groups that perform here, that sing here, that lead the music ministry? Yes. I love it. All right. I have one special gratitude that I want you folks to have. We've had a lot of really good accompanists for each of the choirs, but this young lady, Jermaine, has done an excellent job of filling in and supporting wherever needed. Could you please give Jermaine a hand? Okay, you know what, you guys? Move up. Peter, just let these folks move in front of you. There you go. Good. You're good. Excellent. I love it. Move up. If you're in a nice red dress, you should be up front. Come up. That's it. Good. Very good. Okay, we're going to start with Joy to the World. Collection is done? Good. Okay. Good. Here. Oh, here. There you go.
Joy to the world, the Lord is
We are truly blessed. Father, you get the final word.
Oh, thank you, Peter. And did you enjoy that? It's so amazing, you know, see our choir, hundreds of people singing, praising God. That is so joyful to be able to, have this church community of St. Matthew's. So we have all the choirs participated in this Christmas concert, and the priests also participate in some ways. You know, traditionally, we have the assistant, a priest would sing. And thank you, Father Patrick, for fulfilling that role. And parishioners have been asking, why don't you sing, Father? I said, when there's no assistant, I'll be singing. But I hope I will always have an assistant here, at least one. So anyway, I'd like to thank in a special way Peter Luongo for directing all this over the years. That's wonderful. Yeah. I'd like also to thank Peter Luongo for taking on the official role as the music director, coordinator of our St. Matthew Parish, for coordinating all the choirs and music groups, so that we can be on the same page, singing hopefully better and more joyful to praise God. And thank you, Peter, for taking on that role. Thank you. And of course, Peter mentioned it already, but Tim McKinnon, who is working very hard. Where's Tim? Did he disappear?
He's working very hard.
Yeah, he's still working very hard, maybe in the kitchen, making coffee or something, but he is working very hard to keep this going, especially during the COVID time and then after COVID time until now. So I'd like to once again officially thank Tim McKinnon very much. And of course, Chow for the sound system and the people for the lights, Cornelius. And of course, our wonderful performers, all the choirs. Once again, please give them thanks. It's so amazing. Thank you. So please keep on the spirit of joy in our own heart. We have only one more week, actually, after this next week. We are already into Christmas, so this year around, Christmas is Advent is short, only 3 weeks plus 1 day, right? So we only have one more week to prepare ourselves. So hopefully we'll keep on this joy until Christmas and over every day in our own life as we are welcoming our Savior into our own heart. So let us give thanks to God for all the blessing that He has given us. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Loving God, we come before you and we trust that you truly present among us, bonding all of us together as one family of faith, as your children, to once again celebrate the birth of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior. We ask you to come into our own hearts and remain with us and give us that peace, that true peace, that you have come to bring to the world. So we ask you to bless each and every one of us, our own families, and the whole community of St. Matthew's during this Advent season and this Christmas season that we are preparing for. We ask this to Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go in peace and serve the Lord. Thank you.